crucified for us,
powerful in virginity, modesty, her offering, a sacrifice on the altar of chastity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Brethren, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who gave St. Catherine of Alexandria to your people as a virgin and an invincible martyr, grant that through her intercession we may be strengthened in faith and constancy and spend ourselves without reserve for the unity of the Church. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but I do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. Love is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, it will be brought to nothing. For we know partially, and we prophesy partially. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk as a child, think as a child, reason as a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. At present, we see indistinctly as in a mirror, but then face to face. At present, I know partially. Then I shall know fully, as I am fully known. So faith, hope, love remain these three, but the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord. Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp, with the ten-stringed lyre chant his praise. Sing to him a new song, pluck the strings skillfully with shouts of gladness. Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. For upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord the earth is full. Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. Blessed the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us, who have put our hope in you. Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own. Alleluia, alleluia. Your words, Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to the crowd, "They will seize and persecute you. They will hand you over to the synagogues and to prisons. They will have you led before kings and governors because of my name. It will lead to your giving testimony. Remember, you are not to prepare your defense beforehand, for I myself will give you a wisdom in speaking, that all your adversaries will be powerless to resist or to refute. You will even be handed over by parents, brothers, relatives, and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but not a hair on your head will be destroyed. By your perseverance, you will secure your lives." The Gospel of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Yesterday, our Lord warned us of those wars and insurrections, those natural calamities that need come. He also told us that those future tribulations must precede the ultimate and final tribulation. Today, before verse 12 begins in our gospel, it says, it was left out in the lectionary, but our Lord very clearly says, before all this begins, in reference to those tribulations from yesterday, before this begins, if you follow me, they will persecute you. They being those religious leaders, civil leaders, parents, siblings, relatives, and friends. They will persecute you if you follow me. Our Lord today in the gospel is being completely honest with us, his disciples, and with his apostles those many years ago. He wants us, like them, to be prepared, to not have any surprises around the corner. He will give us the words to speak in those moments of persecution, and those adversaries of ours will be powerless to resist or to refute those words, because they are the words of Christ. Very keenly, our Lord tells his disciples, and he tells us, that in persecution, there is always an opportunity to preach the gospel. Be it any category of they, be it family, friends, relatives, civil leaders, or religious leaders, there is always an opportunity in those persecutions. This might be a good reminder during these holiday seasons that as we gather as family, there's always those conversations with family members that maybe we want to avoid, that maybe religion is a conversation killer at the family table, but it can be an opportunity for us to witness our faith to them, an opportunity to preach the gospel by our authenticity, by our love, and by our living it in all aspects of our life. Now, it's important for us to recognize that all of the apostles faced persecution. They followed our Lord, and his words were accurate. All of them, save for John, died a martyr's death. The nation church was fruitful, not in spite of the persecution, but because of the persecution in those early years of Christianity. And rightly, we are told from early on in the history of the church that the blood of the martyrs is the seed of the church. What does our Lord show us in this gospel passage today in speaking of this persecution that we as his followers will expect? It reminds us of the seriousness of the faith, the true weight of our religion, the principles we hold, and of the moral teachings we adhere to. Each of the lives of the martyrs is a witness to the seriousness of our Catholic faith. Our Lord also shows us that God believes in man and woman enough to not offer us an easy or a comfortable way, but a heroic way, that way to be a saint. It also, our Lord tells us that we are promised that we will not face those persecutions alone, but we can assure that he is with us, and as he clearly said, he will provide those insights, those words of wisdom we need to be able to soften our neighbors' hearts, our family members, to be able to bring them home to the fullness of truth. He will give us that strength, that courage. In many ways, the prison of persecution can become that palace, the scaffold, a throne, the storms of life, a summer breeze with the ease and the grace of God. And then also our Lord speaks of safety beyond the threats of earth, that place where not a hair on our head will be destroyed. Our Lord tells us the reality of heaven amidst those persecutions, that we need not fear those who can attack the body, but only those who can attack the soul and body. Today, Holy Mother Church honors St. Catherine of Alexandria, who is a witness, most assuredly, of the seriousness of being Catholic. She converted at the age of 18 and remained a virgin for her whole life. And after her conversion, she went and debated 50 philosophers who there were spurred to conversion themselves, along with 200 other soldiers of the emperor. In the end, all of them, Catherine, all 50 philosophers, and those 200 soldiers were martyred for Jesus Christ. Let us ask ourselves, do we prefer to die for Jesus by embracing humbly that ridicule, that being mocked, those persecutions we face? Or do we prefer to live by denying him, live in the false sense that the world tells us that as earthly riches, the rewards the world offers us, they will all rust, they will all lose their beauty, and they will pass away. Christ alone gives us that true life, eternal life, and he promises us that perfect happiness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. May the offerings we bring in celebration of Blessed Catherine win your gracious acceptance, O Lord, we pray, just as the struggle of her suffering and passion was pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning their merits you crown your own gifts. By their way of life you offer us an example. By communion with them you give us companionship. By their intercession, sure support, so that encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us and win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so with angels and archangels and with the great multitude of saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them we offer you the sacrifice of praise that they offered for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The Lamb who is at the center of the throne will lead them to the spring of the water of life. Let us pray. O God, who bestowed on Blessed Catherine a crown among the saints for her twofold triumph of virginity and martyrdom, grant, we pray, through the power of this sacrament, that bravely overcoming every evil, we may attain the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Fear our protection is